According to the Auditor General's report, Moni University had budgeted to collect non-tax revenue of 1.17 billion shillings from tuition fees and hostel rental fees from the university tenants in the financial year 2021-2022, but the entity only collected 912 million shillings, representing a performance of 77.58%, which negatively affected implementation of planned activities, which raised concerns to members of parliament.
You only collected 911. What happened? That is where the concern of the Auditor General arises from.
Chair, it is a challenge that most students study and then pay fees towards the end of the semester. And because of that, some of them actually did not pay the fees, and the university was unable to collect.
The committee also established that the public university failed to collect tuition amounting to 338 million shillings from the university students who did not complete their courses.
However, it should be noted that COVID-19 pandemic affected the release of development funds in the 2020/2021 financial year. That equally affected the completion of multipurpose health science laboratory building.
It includes the uncollected fees, which is declared in the receivables, but the transfer to treasury is the actual cash which was collected and transferred.
That would mean that you may have had a different target and you still underscored the target, and then you... I think that was the issue of the Auditor General, that you should do proper planning.
However, officials attributed failure to collect the fees from defaulters on COVID-19 pandemic, which led to a shortfall in recruitment of students.
The university has improved on that, and that's the reason why we have progressively collected now 1,397,000,000 in the following financial year. This means there is an improvement in the projections of NTERA.
The committee queried university officials for failure to fully implement programmed activities worth 3.642 billion shillings, yet the entity spent all the money. For example, the university failed to purchase office and ICT equipment, while 36 mothers instead of 70 mothers were given care at their homes by 36 students who delivered them in Arua Referral Hospital in their homes for 7 days each.
Now you tell us that you defied that and decided to do that way. But where you have by cash limit, where you have this money, you don't commit yourself.
So sometimes you start the processes early, but you commit when you are signing a contract. You don't sign a contract before you are sure you have the money.
And none implemented at all, okay? You give a schedule, which activities this where, and the money is relating to this. And actually, as we are responding to that, that's when you will even understand the chairman's question better.
Story by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.